Jordan.
Wow. Well, welcome back to Harbor. That was President Obama Tuesday, just yesterday, on his way into a lunch with Senate Republicans behind closed doors. The president sounded optimistic going in, but what happened inside? The New York Times reports that Senator John McCain, who he beat in the campaign, quote, lashed out at the administration in that room for its portrayal of the new immigration law in Arizona, and that Tennessee's Bob Corker, quote, suggested the administration had been less than sincere in trying to seek a bipartisan deal on financial regulation. Texas's John Cornyn told Roll Call, the newspaper of Capitol Hill, that the president appeared to be somewhat insulated from what actually is going on in the country. And Kansas Senator Pat Roberts told the Associated Press that the president, quote, needs to take a Valium before he comes in and talks to Republicans. He's pretty thin-skinned, the senator said. As for the president himself, on his way out, he said, we had a good, frank discussion on a whole range of issues. Really? Is that what it sounds like to you? What does the president get out of these get-togethers with Republicans? David Corns, a Washington bureau chief, the Washington bureau chief for Mother Jones, and a columnist for PoliticsDaily.com. And Ernest Istook is former Republican congressman from Oklahoma. I want to start with David Corn, who's sitting with me. David, it seems to me he goes in there. The shot against the president is that he uses Republicans as props, that he's really not in there to deal. And I have to ask the question, why is it impossible? Is this an unstoppable force, meaning a movable object, which is really not unstoppable because the object is immovable? Or is it that they're not really good negotiators? They don't try to figure out ahead of time what the other side might buy.
Well, it depends. Which side are you talking about?
I'm asking about both. I'm trying to be even-handed because we do need some deal-making to get some stuff done, like immigration reform, regulatory reform. We do need both sides.
Well, the meeting showed me that there's not much social evolution beyond high school. I mean, these senators come out, and they whine and complain that the president's testy. He uses the word I too much. He's duplicitous. I mean, from the president's perspective, he's accomplishing things. Health care reform, financial reform. He got three Republicans, the two main Republicans, and Senator Brown from Massachusetts to sign on, so that makes the bill somewhat bipartisan. I mean, I guess the question is expectations. This is the argument the White House makes. We're happy to work with you, but you have to understand, they say this to the Republicans, that we're in the driver's seat. We're the majority. We get most of what we want. We're happy to talk to you about some of the things you want, but we're not going to change our overall
approach.
Okay, that's
it. Let me go to Congressman Istook. Congressman Istook, it looks like they're both fighting over what menu to use. President Obama goes in there, he wants sushi or something a little hipper. The Republicans want meat and potatoes. They want meatloaf or something. Because I look at this set of issues. He wants to talk about immigration reform, regulatory reform, things like that, climate change. The Republicans want to talk about jobs, the deficit, debt, things like that. They have a different menu they want to fight over.
Well, Chris, you're right. There certainly is a difference in the menus. There's also a difference in the perception. I think if the president had a better understanding of what's really going on, he probably would not have walked into that room without a teleprompter. Those meetings, you know, they're off the record. They're behind closed doors. And typically, you can go out and you can say what you said in the meeting. You're not normally going to breach protocol and talk about what someone else said. But they're talking about how the president behaved in that. The problem is, to get the rest of the agenda through that he wants to, he needs Democrat votes, even from his own party. They're skittish. They read the polls. They've seen some Democrats, like Alan Mollahan, for example, that have gone down, and Arlen Specter, that have gone down on elections. The president realizes that to push some things through, he's got to get some help from the other side, but he doesn't understand just how badly he has alienated not only a lot of these Republican senators, but so many people all across the country that used to be on his side.
Well, okay, I'm not sure that's entirely true, but your thoughts, David.
Can we be fair here? I mean, the president has had to deal with the Republican Party, particularly on the House side, that has called him a socialist, that in the campaign said he wanted to power with terrorists, that makes common cause with the most extreme Tea Party activists who compare him to Hitler
this
and the Nazis.
This is not about hurt feelings.
Why would you deal with a guy you consider a Nazi?
I mean, listen, John,
that's your starting point.
John Boehner gets up there and says, health care will lead to the apocalypse. And then he says, the president doesn't deal with me. I mean, which way is it? If the Republicans want to sit down and act like mature partners, they're free to do that, Congressman.
But David, a majority of Americans want to repeal that health care bill, according to polls.
Isn't there a general perception, Congressman, in your party, the Republican Party, that if you deal with Barack Obama, you lose the next primary? if you have any dealings with him, looking at the Bennett on talking about health care, any conversation on any issue, any meeting of minds on anything is grounds for removal from the party in today's Republican Party, isn't it?
Well, there is a certain perception that tracks that, but it's not based upon personalities. It's based upon the issues. It's based upon trillions of dollars worth of deficit spending that we're seeing. It's based upon a government mandate telling you you must buy health care coverage or else. It's based upon the issues, not upon personalities.
Bob Bennett didn't do any of those things. All Bob Bennett did was buy into Bush's TARP and discuss with Ron Wyden an alternative on health care to the president's plan, and he lost
Then let's call it clearly. If that's what the congressman believes, then let's give up this, you know, this ghost of bipartisanship. The Democrats have majority power. Let them pass these bills and see what the voters say in November. It's quite simple.
The voters say repeal the health care bill.
Let's take a look at something. Let's talk politics for a second and not philosophy. We're arguing philosophy here. Here's President Obama at a fundraiser for Barbara Boxer last night. Let's listen to what the president said.
And I also, by the way, am sympathetic to the fact that it's hard for Republicans to work with me right now. Because there are members of their base who, if somebody even smiles at me, they think, you're a traitor. You smiled at Obama. You're nice to him. You were polite. And if you're rude to Obama, we can raise money. So, you know, the incentive structure right now for cooperation within the Republican Party is not real strong. So I'm sympathetic to that.
The governor of Florida hugged the president. For that, he was thrown out of the party. Congressman, is that grounds for removal these days?
No, it's not how you see him on personal basis. Senator Tom Coburn from Oklahoma remains good friends with Barack Obama. He talks about their personal friendship. He's not in any difficulty back home. Why? Because he stands up against the president's big government and big spending agenda. It's about the economy, stupid. It really is. It's not about personalities.
Well, I think we'll see that come November. I mean, the president has succeeded in passing his stimulus plan, the health care plan. Financial reform is probably going to pass in the next couple of weeks, and he'll have a record of accomplishments. The Republicans have opted out, basically, and not participated. Most of these bills are going through with very few Republican votes. I think it's good for voters. There will be a clear choice.
You know what the danger is to the Democrats? Republicans carry the House by one vote. They get the subpoena power.
That's
true. People like Daryl Issa will do nothing but subpoena this administration for 2 years till they get the White House.
And then they'll probably lose the Congress for that.
That's what they want to do. Thank you, David Corn. Sir, thank you, Congressman Instuk. Thanks for coming on again.
Thanks, Chris.